Hey guys, welcome to today's video. We're going to be talking about Jameis Winston as well as Taysom Hill. And we're going to be determining via a little bit of film session on the Jaguars game yesterday who should be the starting quarterback for this Saints roster next season. Before we get started, though, please drop a quick like and sub on today's video. That really helped my channel grow. I really appreciate that. With that said, let's dive right into the video, and I hope you enjoy. Taysom Hill, Jameis Winston. This is a quarterback, a little bit of a quarterback battle, you know, in New Orleans. It's going to be Jameis Winston who's going to be the starter. It's going to be him, and I'm going to explain why using some film from yesterday's Jags game. But overall, just Jameis Winston makes more sense as the starter. You know, I think he just adds more to the offense, and I'll show you why I think he adds more to the offense in today's video. So now then, let's dive right into the film session, and I hope you enjoy. So number one thing I want to show you here is, you know, Jameis Winston obviously in the pocket here. And he's going to have this receiver running basically an out route to the outside of the field. And basically what I want you to see in this throw here is not necessarily the accuracy, because Taysom Hill still has accuracy. I don't really want to doubt Taysom Hill's accuracy. But what I want to show you here is pure arm strength that I see from Jameis Winston. This pass is a bullet. It's accurate. It's right to the chest of the receiver. And it's in a really good spot to pick up the first down. Taysom Hill, in my opinion, doesn't quite have the same arm strength as Jameis Winston. Winston is a lot more powerful with his arm, a lot more direct throwing the football, and I think that's something that's really powerful for the Saints offense. They need a quarterback who's not afraid to throw the football deep downfield, who's not afraid to throw the ball with power, and I think Jameis Winston simply has more power than Taysom Hill, and I'll show you why I think that comparing a Taysom Hill throw that's kind of similar to this. And as I said, I'd show you a Taysom Hill throw that's a little bit similar. It's not exactly the same. It's not a complete out route for this receiver, but this receiver is going to run to that outer half of the field, outer left side of the field, and you're just going to see the difference in the accuracy and the arm strength. You see, you know, it's a little bit of a different route. He's getting past his quarter first, right? It's a little bit more of a go route at first, or at least acts like a go route. You see how he really gets around that corner. He's supposed to wait for that, and you see how he kind of lobs it up there. It's more of a curl, but it's not really a curl. It's he acts like it's a curl because he kind of doesn't put as much power on it, allows for the route to evolve. But you see, there just quite isn't that same just pure arm strength and that direction to that throw. That throw is a little bit loopy. It's not crisp. With Jameis Winston, it's crisp. With Taysom Hill, it's not as crisp. It looks a little awkward almost. But at the end of the day, you got to remember, Taysom Hill's an athlete. He's not necessarily just a quarterback. He can do a variety of things. And I think at the end of the day, what Jameis Winston's able to do in the pocket, throw the ball with a little bit more, you know, a little bit more arm strength. He just looks a little bit more crisp in the pocket. Looks a little bit more comfortable than Taysom Hill, who I just don't think has the same arm strength as Jameis Winston. And at the end of the day, that is a big asset, especially when you need to fit balls into tight spaces. So I think that that's a big part of that why I think that Jameis Winston is going to end up winning the starting quarterback battle. Simply, he's just got a little bit more crispness to his game. Plus, how about when you can make a throw like this? You know, Jameis Winston is going to be under center. And this is the thing I like about Jameis Winston. He can really utilize the play action game here. You see how, number one, let's check the defense. It's going to be man coverage. So it's going to be man here. And then this is going to be a single high safety in the deep end. And basically, this receiver here is going to run that route. It's a post route towards the middle of the field. And the goal is to get in behind that defense, behind that single high safety. But more importantly, though, I love how Jameis Winston is able to utilize this play action game. And you see how this affects the defense. You see how this entire defense opens this way. All of these guys move this way because of this play action. So really successful play action. Good job him selling the fake. Next things I want to show you, the protection. Really good protection here. And then more importantly, look over here. You can see how there's three guys on this one receiver, but Jameis Winston has that arm strength, that has that vision to really take the ball over the top. He sees this open space over here. He trusts his receiver to go up and be faster than the other guy and really allows him to see this area and throw that ball over the top. Taysom Hill can make that throw, but Jameis Winston can do it at a higher level. You got to remember, Jameis Winston had 33 touchdowns and 30 interceptions. 30 interceptions the last time he started games, right, with Tampa Bay Bucks. This showcases, I mean, he threw for over 5,000 yards. This guy can throw the football, and he can throw it deep downfield with consistency, and, you know, I think with improved accuracy. We're not going to see those same 30 interceptions again. I really am confident in that. And look at just how great this throw is. Right over the top of the defense, It's a tight window, tight throw. I don't have another angle of it, but, you know, this is a really good throw by Jameis Winston. These are the kinds of throws that I think Jameis Winston can make, but Taysom Hill can't make. And I think that's another big thing that's going to make Jameis Winston really the favorite for this quarterback spot. And then how about this play, too, from Jameis Winston? It's one-on-one coverage right here for Winston on the bottom of your screen. And it's pretty much going to just be a little bit of a, you know, it's going to be pretty much going to the end zone. He's just going to try and beat his quarter. And Marquez Callaway, he's trying to get past his quarter and use his speed and his athleticism to get by and take it to the end zone on pretty much a go route. What Jameis Winston sees is he automatically knows that this is a one-on-one matchup here. He knows it's a one-on-one matchup, but he knows there isn't a safety on that side of the field. I don't have the camera angle to show you that. I'm sorry. But nonetheless, you see how he, number one, he sees the pressure coming, but he holds it there just long enough to get a good throw off to make sure there's separation and put that ball on the absolute money. You see how there's barely any space. It's a good job by the receiver getting that, getting that position on him. But nonetheless, there's nobody in this area. And Jameis Winston simply has to hold on into the pocket, wait for the little bit of separation to open up here, and allow for his receiver to run into this open space. And that's a really good read by him, understanding that there's no safety, right? He sees that there's pretty much a blitz here with all these guys. There's one, two, three guys back here. That means that there's eight guys here, which means, yeah, of course, one or two guys is going to drop back, but it still means that the blitz is coming. Realizes he's going to have to get the ball out quickly, gets the ball out quickly, waits just for the last second, actually does a really good job here. The Saints offensive line and running back here, really good job making his allowing for as much time as possible, allows Winston to take that ball over the top, but Winston makes the most of his opportunities, puts the ball on the money for a really nice touchdown grab. So I really like what Winston does. I mean, he looks confident, and he looks really accurate with the football. He went, 9 for 10, 123 yards and two touchdowns in this game, and I think he really earned that starting job just because of how accurate he looked, how confident he looked, and how settled in he looked with this Saints offense. A really good job here by Jameis Winston on this throw. And I hate to add insult to injury for a guy like Taysom Hill, but these are two plays that really got my head scratching. Like, oh my God, nope. I prefer Jameis Winston so much. And of course, Jameis Winston's made boneheaded plays in his life before. But Taysom Hill, these plays in today's game, especially in a game where really it was for the starting job, you could not be making plays like this. For example, right here, he's got to get the ball out. There's one, two, three, four guys pretty much closing in on that area. There's nowhere to go with this football to really run outside. There's no really option. You got to dump it down here, or you got to dump it down here. There's a wide receiver open. They're just out of the picture. But instead, Jameis just you see how he's open right there. Try and fire that ball in. But by standing around for maybe 2-3 seconds, now he gets absolutely walloped. Good job protecting the football. You know, going to the ground, not fumbling it, because I mean that could have easily been a fumble there. But this is just a bad decision from Taysom Hill. Either get up and run, throw the football either here or here, or, you know, just take the sack or throw the ball away. But instead, he waits and waits and waits, indecisive, and then, you know, gets sacked. So that's obviously not a good play there for Taysom Hill. And that was one of those plays in today's game where I was like, nope, I don't feel confident Taysom Hill being the starting quarterback. Similarly, this is another play where I was shaking my head. What is going on here? With this play, it's going to be the receiver on an out route. Taysom Hill is looking for this receiver the entire time. What he doesn't understand is that there's a linebacker here that's going to drop into coverage. And you see him try just force a throw. He's trying to force a throw, right? His entire mindset from the get-go is to look at him. Look how he turns his head immediately after the snap to this receiver. Linebacker can easily read that, okay? And Taysom Hill, I mean, there's not a ton of separation here. Also, there is a defender on the other side over here, and there's just not a lot of space. Also, this ball is thrown behind him. This ball should be out in front, but it can't be out in front because there's a defender here. So this is just a bad throw into a bad spot. It almost gets picked off. It doesn't actually end up getting picked off. It ends up being ruled incomplete, but it's not an accurate throw. It needs to be thrown in front, but by a tiny little bit, maybe here if he has any chance to go to this receiver. But you know, he targets him right off the get-go, really looks at him, and it makes it really easy for this linebacker to make a play on the football. So at the end of the day, this is another play from Taysom Hill today where I was like, nope, I'm not confident with him being the starter. So with that said, I mean, I think Jameis Winston has earned the starting job for this New Orleans Saints team. I really do. I mean, at the end of the day, you know, 9 for 10, 123 yards, two touchdowns compared to Taysom Hill's, you know, one touchdown at 140 or so passing yards, but a lot worse completion percentage. I mean, he was in there for six or seven drives, where Jameis Winston had three drives, you know, two touchdowns on three drives. And the other drive stalled because the offensive line had two false start penalties, I'm pretty sure. So at the end of the day, I really like what I saw from Jameis Winston. He looked confident. He looked cool in the pocket. His arm strength was really there, making accurate, crisp passes. With Taysom Hill, I just think there's more things that can go wrong. I think Jameis Winston opens up this offense a lot more. At the end of the day, I just think that what he's able to do, throwing the football from the pocket as a pocket passer, is something that will give some, you know, some clarity and some consistency to this offense. Although Winston has had high interception totals in the past, I'm not concerned with that. I really think that after learning behind Drew Brees, sitting behind Drew Brees for last year, I think that he's definitely learned in that regard. But also, I think that he's in a position where he's got the bigger arm. He's got the better mechanics. And I think that at the end of the day, we've seen that he can be a top. He's the potential to be a top 10 quarterback in the NFL, you know, at times in his career. Even when he was throwing 33 touchdowns and 30 interceptions, when he was on, he was absolutely on. There was a reason he went high in the first round a few years ago, because he's got that potential. Am I saying he's a top 10 quarterback, or am I saying he's going to be a top 10 quarterback in the NFL this year? Absolutely not. But I think that his ceiling is a lot higher than Jameis Winston's. I mean, I think his ceiling is a lot higher than Taysom Hill's, where Taysom Hill, you know, he's much more of a runner, much more of an athlete playing quarterback rather than a pure quarterback. I think Winston is going to just allow for the Saints offense to really open up a little bit more. Even though Taysom Hill would give you the ability to run the football a little bit more with the quarterback position, I think Winston being a pure pocket passer with a really good arm strength allows for the field to open up more, and especially with fast receivers that we saw today. I think that that's going to be big for the Saints offense. So I think at the end of the day, using the film, looking, you know, seeing what I saw in this Jags game, I think Jameis Winston really should be the starter for this New Orleans Saints team.
And with that said, that's pretty much going to end the video for today. Did you agree with my analysis? Why or why not? Leave your comments and thoughts in the comment section down below. I'd love to hear what you guys have to say. Also, if you're new around here, please drop a like and a sub on today's video. I'd really appreciate that. And with that said, I hope you enjoyed the video. And until next time, see ya.